During the 1800s, America had two political parties. One of the two were the Federalists, who valued centralization of government and had a strict following of the Constitution. The other group, the Democratic Republicans, opted for states' rights, approving of the Constitution because they believed it would give more power to states. But in this election, who were the president?
Thank you very much.
A feud between three.
I am Aaron Burr. I'm here to win this presidential election as the best Democratic Republican. Why? Because I'm a better person than those other two losers. Also, I'm way more relatable than Jefferson. He's a rich white slave owner. Seriously?
My name is John Adams. Did that work? I should be reelected as the United States president so I can keep federalist values in society. And I want to keep strong centralized government. Yeah, I passed the Alien and Sedition Acts, which totally went against the First Amendment right of freedom of speech, but people make mistakes. Let's look past that.
I'm recording.
I'm Thomas Jefferson. Why should I be president? I have plenty of reasons. Number one, John Adams had a really terrible presidency. Like, come on guys, it was pretty darn bad. Number two, I follow loose following of the Constitution, which means, you know, states gets more rights. And come on guys, call me a pro-French elitist all you want, but at least I'm not Adams wanting a whole monarchy. Like, he wants to be called his Royal Highness. Peculiar gloat.
For the first time in American history, there was a tie with 23 electoral votes between the candidates, Thomas Jefferson and Aaron Burr.
Gentlemen, what do we do now? I think we should have the House of Representatives vote to break the tie and decide who will be our next president.
You know, in the future, we shall make 12th Amendment, which will make it so there is no more ties. The Electoral College will vote for the president and the vice
who
president.
Is this guy?
There no majority vote for one candidate, then the House of Representatives would have the power to determine who will become the president or vice president.
Nah.
I knew you'd vote for me.
Hello, Congressman. We have the power to turn the direction of the polls. But then again, who better to trust than Alexander Hamilton's opinion? For he has such a high standing as an old founding father and a high reliable policymaker.
Thomas Jefferson is the lesser of two evils. Burr has no political platform. He can't choose what he wants for himself. God only knows that he'll go along with what everyone wants needlessly.
And the winner is Thomas Jefferson.
I accept you as my vice president.
Hey, Hamilton! This is what you get for political slander.